Okay, let's try this a different way. How do we do it differently? So I've reloaded back to the beginning of the video. Sorry for the false start. So we know he'll move a little bit if someone's in front of him. Plus he has a special skill that does stupid amounts of damage. We just try to kill the guys up here first. We'll try to do it a little bit differently. The trick... That is garbage. That almost never happens. That's like 1 in 10 or 1 in 20. The trouble I see is the mage... I don't know how we can kill the mage without the double wing knights causing problems. But let's just be aggressive. Let's pretend I was not wishy-washy and just attacked. What would have happened if I did it like this? And no one has a range 3 attack on this one. Oh, you might notice that I don't have Bernard right now. That's a mistake, actually. You can put Don Hort in your active 12-member group. I was hoping that would let me control him. It does not. So Bernard is missing. We would actually be a little bit better off if we had Bernard here. Just in case you're wondering. Like, we could have 13 characters for this fight because Don Hort's non-controllable. But you could also, like, manually put him in your group, switch someone out, and it does not help. I had a hunch that maybe I'd try it. I thought, you know, why not? Alright, so David lures the mage out. That's good. He might be able to withstand a single hit. Era goes pretty quickly. Maybe she can heal him. We'll be in the same situation here where Medion needs to really work on the mage. But then actually, it's much less of a priority. The mage, I didn't even notice. The mage can only use freeze 3 once. It can use freeze 1 now, which will do... let's see, he did 14 damage to someone with... actually a fair bit of ice resistance. So it's probably like maybe 16 or so base damage. And let's see, what's the difference between freeze 1 and freeze 3? Where's the girl? Back here. Sorry, guys. The difference between freeze 1 and 3 is 8 damage. So a freeze 1 should be around 8 or 9 base for him, I'm going to guess. That's not too bad, honestly. So we might just ignore that. Go for the... Let's just kill... Well, that guy's almost dead. How's the turns gonna go here? 21, we've got... Hera's pretty quick. She goes pretty early. She should go... She should have already gone, honestly. Alright, we're gonna... We're gonna start working on the wing knights. They're probably the most dangerous because of their ability to fly and the ranged attack. So if I could finish them off quicker, that would help. Alright, Zero. How far can Hedoba move? She can actually move far enough to hit with a freeze 3, those two. So we're gonna have... Zero help on this side to speed this up a little bit. Well, maybe. This is assuming he does any damage. Yeah. It's barely worth it. Zero is... He's kind of not turning out that well so far. Like, it's hard to say. He might end up better long term. But, like, remember Eldar? Like, once she started getting weapon skills up, she turned really awesome. Zero's, like, he started okay... But he's been getting worse, kind of. Like, he's not really keeping up with the rest of the team so far. Alright, and then this was... This is the reason I trained her up, is to get long-range magic. Long-range freeze is so good. This spell is basically why I usually consider freeze magic to be better than fire or bolt. Good damage, long-range. It's very valuable. Okay, Okay, so these guys will probably both attack Medion. That's... We already know he should live through this. Without any real trouble. So I think we're probably okay here. Synthesis. We used Golem last time, but we don't need to... Golem, the summon's too slow. One of the problems with summons is it takes longer for the animation, so... I'm not going to be using them all that often unless I need to. It's like playing Final Fantasy VII. As awesome as Bahamut Zero is, it just takes so long. Alright, we're going to use... Are we going to heal or are we going to attack here? She could probably kill it. I wish I'd... I think this wing... Only one Wing Knight's attack, right? Yeah, definitely only one. And I think it was this one that moved over. Because they didn't start together. So if we can actually kill this guy before he gets an action, that would be very beneficial. This might work out really, really well. Lots of damage. Good. Alright. This is much better than try number one. Alright. Now this guy's going to go fairly soon. The problem is we know that the boss can jump down and then the mercenary can kill Anvil, so... I'm gonna put Campbell right here. One or the other can attack him until the bird is dead. And we'll just top Medion off in case the boss goes after Medion. Or, you know, nearly top him off. It's fine. I wonder, maybe the regret hit takes you down to exactly... It's possible the regret hit takes you down to exactly 1 HP, honestly. Scary. This is fine. I guess if Campbell had attacked it, it's vaguely possible Rock could have finished it off there. Especially if you get one more person to attack. Yeah. Now, Julian might die, but I don't really care about his friendships, so it doesn't matter as much. Wow, nice. And I was kind of hoping to get him a level up anyway, so that's good. Now, it may be possible that Julian has poor or below average pre-promotion stats, but now that he's promoted, maybe his stats are going to grow faster than anyone else's. It could happen. Well, it looks like we're pretty much set now. Has anyone taken any significant damage? Just level up loss. Oh, I think we got it. We nailed it. I think we got a little bit lucky on the turn order with the second Wing Knight. If it had gone earlier, it would have... Well, I don't think it would have killed Medion, but it could have changed targets. You never know when they're going to be sneaky and double attack somebody. Doesn't really matter. I guess Eryudo could have used Aura and healed up. He could have used Aura to long-range heal Medion. That would have been smart. Oh, and, well, I should have had the mage dead by now, too, I guess. But not a big deal. So now I'll try to kill the bird before he gets a turn, if I can. With my bird! Actually, no, I'm going to have Zero finish off the mage. Because Zero is so weak... I don't think he could kill the bird. He only does like 10 damage to them. And he still barely did enough damage to the Master Mage. Come on, I need to see like plus 2 attack here. You've got to catch up. Okay, that was exactly what I needed to see. Any worse than I would have been a little bit worried. But if he starts getting plus 2 level ups, that could do. I think we got this. Excellent. Well, it's going to be a little bit longer episode today. We'll wrap the chapter up. Getting ahead of myself. Counting my eggs, you know. But seriously, I think we're good. How much defense do you have these days? 21? I wonder... It's 24 base damage. It shouldn't kill him. His skill... I don't know how his skill works, though. put him a little bit further away just in case. Oh yeah, and the Wing Knight's at full. Yeah, Zero wasn't gonna kill the Wing Knight, that's for sure. Alright. Now I would like Hedva to get some XP. I was gonna say level up, but that's not gonna happen. Just pretend I put a normal save down. I'm just doing this because I want her to get a kill, but it might cost her life, and I don't want to redo the whole battle or nothing stupid like that. You sure get a lot of XP anyway. I was trying to get everyone to level 2 for this fight. It hasn't worked perfectly, obviously. So I'm gonna put Medion not up there, but close, so that the boss might go for him, and then we can jump on him. Yeah, I'm not running up there. I'm gonna let him come to us, and I'll try to give Medion the defense bonus. He might go for Julian, who's got less defense, so. Come on down, Mr. Krivort. He didn't come on down. He did not show me what I got. I hate it when bosses don't. Something. Look, man. Look, it's late. It's like 12 o'clock blue time. Here I am recording for you guys. My words fail me. They don't cooperate. Cooperate's the word. Alright, let's kill him. No, you're too slow. Alright, let's not kill him. That's why I didn't want to run up here. The stairs really slow people down. So he's got an axe, right? Yeah, so we're going to want to make sure people who are attacking him have less spears equipped in general. So power hatchet is good. I don't think we're going to be able to finish him off in a single round, but... we could fight Arrawnt. Brother, I've come to fight you. Nah, I'm gonna leave him alone. Beat up Krivort. Take out your crony first. Right in front of your face while you watch. That'll teach him. Wonder if she can use like a sword attack. Just jump up and slice his legs or something. Nah, she can't actually hit him from here. Oddly enough, see, that's weird, because normally you can't throw a shuriken to an adjacent square, but here you can, and even though it's like, so it's like plus one or minus one to your range because it's so high, but she could still target the square over as well. That's really odd. Anyway, might as well get in the attack. No one else can do a melee attack from here, so... as well. Alright, Hedva. Yeah, you're gonna stand here. No, you're not. You're one of the very, very few right now that can go range 3. If I brought Bernard, this would be a little bit easier as well. Maybe we've got it. Maybe he's gonna die before he even gets in action. Zephyrus! See, guys, she's a real summoner now. She's gonna learn her own summon. She doesn't need any rods to teach her how to summon stuff. This could do a lot of damage boosted by Hedva. Also, I don't know Krivort's resistances, so... actually, and I don't even know what element Earth uses, so that's good. That's a lot of damage. Maybe he's weak to earth magic. I think we got him, guys. I think Brock is gonna finish this sucker. piece o' cake. Rock the man. Rock is doing really well, actually. He's been getting a lot of kills. Is this the end for the Executor? The most powerful warship in all of Dystonia? And for Krawort's elite soldiers? Since the situation has deteriorated this far, I shall have to finish it myself. Ha! It's not a Arrawnt! It's a trap! Oh no. I forgot something.
Can you break the barrier? Come at me with all you've got!
You guys want to take bets on what I forgot?
How I blundered! How have I blundered? How I have blundered! Blundered have I! To think I would be defeated, and that the Prince Arrawnt I believed was a priest of Balbulzum. Gah!
So, maybe all along, Arrawnt's a good guy, and this is just a fake out with a masked monk. The problem here is, I didn't bring the Albus of Orb. I put it away when I was showing you guys all the stats. I forgot to equip it. I was gonna give it to Zero, because, like, you know, he can fly around and use it on people. And I totally forgot to bring it. So, here's hoping we're not screwed. What does this guy have, anyway? Spark. Oh, that's gonna hurt. He doesn't have a lot of HP, but, this is gonna be fun! Let's test her out. So normally, let's just for comparison's sake, his base attack is 45 here. He also gets plus 10, so he's 55 base attack power. Should do a lot of damage versus 26. So we're talking like almost 30 damage here. But let's see what we actually get. And I bet you it's not going to be 30. Well, that gives a multiplier of like plus 40 or 50%. And we still got not even 20.
Dang.
Like, we could have almost one-shot him there if we hadn't messed it up. I think... Oh, you don't have resist. It's Hedoba that has resist. But I could do this. No, not that. The other one. Whip. The old power onk. And... I mean, I don't think this will do much damage, but it's better than zero, right? It's gonna be zero, isn't it? It's gonna be zero. It's seven! That's not bad! That's something. Uh-oh, here he goes! So he's targeting the rock. I don't think this will one-shot anybody. It'll probably do 15 damage. Yes! I am so good at guessing spell damage, guys. I deserve all of your BlueAnkylo points. But I'll only take one. Everyone loses one BlueAnkylo point and I add them to my stash. Because that was pretty good. Prophetic, practically. Alright, well now he's dead. There's no way. I don't even care if you've got some kind of defense. I don't know if it's worth attacking with zero. Actually, he might get a weapon type advantage. Yeah, he's got the holy sort of, holy wing, so, holy attack. So he gets a little bit of bonus damage. It's acceptable. I was thinking of leaving that spot for someone else, of course. Hera! Well, resistance would be nice, but it's not gonna matter. Because we're gonna kill this fool. Zephyrus. Oh yeah, let's check the stats on it first. So, I know I spent a lot of work trying to get Freeze level 3, which is cool, and it's better for area of effect. But Zephyrus is what makes Hedva really, really good. Probably better than the other mages. It's a range 3 summon that has a very high base damage, and she learns it so early. So, welcome to die. Now you guys know why I was trying to get her that level up. Oh look, she summoned another girl with crazy bird wings. Now I understand it only did 18 damage, but imagine if it wasn't like super resistant to everything. Actually, the The golem might do more damage, depending on what kind of weird element it counts as. It might count as, like, light or dark or something that he doesn't resist. Well, he probably resists dark, I would suspect. Now, David would do a lot of damage if I could get him in range, but... Actually, yeah. Well, David, maybe David can finish him off. Let's see. Which weapon is stronger here? Slightly. That's pretty close to the 55 that that Campbell had that did 18 damage. So this is chance to kill here. Yeah. David. He's my man. And he gets his level up. And he even gets some defense. Commando. Alright. That wasn't too bad. It would have been easier if we had someone with the Elvisum Orb ready to break the barrier. We probably would have been doing like 50% more damage or something.
I have been defeated! I can't believe you're that strong!
Especially without using your stupid holy magic. Where are Prince Arrawnt and Honesty, the Pegasus Knight?
Wouldn't you like to know, Rogan? Wouldn't you like to know?
What has happened? Don't tell me they...
There's no need to worry. Honesty is locked up in the hold, and Prince Arrawnt is...
Self-destruct initiated! Yeah, there you go. What'd you think was going to happen? You have 1 minute to vacate this boat. Seriously, looking at the smoke's not helping. Anytime you want to get off the boat, guys.
The executor has overheated because we blew up the boss. We're in danger here.
It was a load-bearing boss again.
When technology fails, it is unpredictable. The executor's steam engine has exploded. We may not be able to save the ship, Prince Medion, but we can ride the waves out here. Honesty, right, let's go save her first.
Straight into the burning ship. It's all good. Don't worry about it, guys. I'm gonna breathe heavily for you guys.
Oh, the poor thing. She must be having a hard time breathing because of the gag she's wearing.
And the smoke. Has the key been located yet? Well, yeah. We brought it with us. Seriously, I could go unlock the door right now. I found the soldier Hasaki! Didn't we have the key already? Oh, maybe we had a different key. Anytime you want to open the door before we all burn to death in the burning ship, don't be afraid. Just hurry up and open the door, or we'll kill you. No? Congratulations, you've opened the door. Now kill him. He obviously works for the masked monks. Oh, they're having a good time in there. Okay, get a room on a not burning ship, you two. Hey, yeah, have fun. Let's go. Uh-oh.
Honesty? What are you doing?
Honestly, Honesty. Those who oppose our plans will disappear with this ship like rubbish under the sea. Fooled you all! Again, that's the third time!
Oh, also, by the way, I said you were gonna die!
Now die!
Nah, now give me that key.
You're not honestly!
Nah, you figured that out! Too late!
That voice. It's BlueAnkylo!
I still haven't recovered from Pink Eye, but I'm back.
I intended to lock all of you up. Unfortunately, I only managed to trap General Rogan. Well, it can't be helped.
You're a bosom priest! I fell into your trap!
At least Campbell was going to stab him. a bozom high priest were to go on the defensive, no matter how strong your force might be, you wouldn't win. Well, if we had brought the Elbasum orb, we would totally whoop his butt. Well, now that my purpose here is fulfilled, I shall take my leave. Oh, running away, are you? Only I run away! When the power of the Staff of Besom was released, I took more damage than expected. A battle in my current condition would be disadvantageous. And after suffering critical damage from an engine explosion, the Executor is no longer worth risking life and limb. Then, you knew that! You locked General Rogan in the brig to send him down with the Executor! The General can't be saved without the key. This ship will sink within a day or so, according to my calculations. Well, 22 hours and a half, to be honest. And General Rogan will go down with it! I could have just stabbed him, but I'm gonna make him wait and slowly drown!
You monster! Where are you surfing off to now?
I'm telling you my plan, because I don't know why.
Bad guys, right? This is very serious, Lord Conrad. Yeah, we know. We must pursue him to get that key. Yeah, we've only got a day. Good luck.
Medion, we have another problem. The ship that's on fire and exploded, you know.
Oh, also.
A Dystonian warship is heading towards us. Turns out there's more than two warships in the fleet. And there's another one.
What's wrong? Why does everyone look so, gloomy? I know we haven't been really part of Chapter 4, but, we want a time to talk to. This, David guy gets all the lines. It's not fair. Used to be just me and Arrawnt every day.
What? A huge flying object which emits lightning? And it is attacking Dystonia Castle. I think that's the capital of the Empire. Maybe. What an unbelievable story. I don't believe it. Bresby, owls never lie. Yes, that's a saying. Hoot! Hoot hoot! Hoot!
The owl says, in order to save General Rogan, we must pursue the High Priest who fled with the key. Yeah.
I speak bird, that's not what he said at all! How horrible! High Priest Fial is likely moving with the aid of flying regiments. Even if you deploy your army after him, they will never catch up with him in time.
Well then what should we do? We only have one bird.
If I depart immediately, I can get there first.
Yeah, just go. So much jibber jabber. Sorry, I'm not reading exactly the lines anymore, guys. You may have noticed.
Certainly, our army is incredibly grateful to you, Zero. There is another problem.
Does the object...
He should just always be bored, that's perfect.
Does the flying object emit, green light? Is it also in the shape of a mushroom?
Because I'm kind of hungry. I could use a glowing radioactive mushroom, you know.
Does the upper portion glow brighter as it casts down lightning, capable of destroying castle walls? I like my mushrooms to be spicy.
Looks like we're having salad.
Ooh! Hoot!
The owl wants to know who the boy is. He's, apparently some sort of magic boy. Who knows? He's got a magic staff.
Gracia, are you hungry for lunch?
Yes!
It's an ancient scripture that tells of the lunch.
The Valkyrie, dome of the evil palace, guided by the Vandal's magic staff, will emit green light and taste heavenly. The lightning it releases will rend your taste buds asunder.
Are you sure that's in the holy text?
This appears, yes, to be my task. If the Walkeries attack can be stopped and served for dinner, the Dystonia Castle should hold me at the dining table. In order for me to approach the Walkery, I'm going to need a little help. It's a big mushroom. I'm going to need more people to cut it up.
I will accept that duty. I'm tired of hanging out with you jerks. I need my own story. But in everyone's story except my own. The battles of Medion army and the battles they face in Saraband, from my perspective, appear to be little more than internal squabbling. You guys are just wasting my time. Compared to that, the opponent Gracie is to challenge is a Vandal. Also, I'm curious as to the taste of his mushroom friend. I continue to fight to defeat the Vandals, all while remembering the sadness of waiting for my father, who never returned. Yes, I have daddy issues. Would you like to know more? So, I will go with Gracia. If I am to be caught up in these ideological conflicts, I would rather battle Vandals than hang out with you. Me too, I'm out of here. See you later, suckers.
I've ceaselessly fought for equality, yet I had lost hope in everything and lost sight of my goals. Equality was perhaps an unrealizable
Look, man, if you want the mushroom, you can just say you're hungry. It's fine. Your path is to the Walkery. Good luck, sir. Get out of here. Quit talking to me. Julian, Donhort, Gracia, get lost. I don't want to see you guys again.
Yeah, the company of those two will be reassuring. I can get them to carry my luggage.
Hoot! Hoot, hoot, hoot! The bird said something about that. I'm gonna go get the key, though. See ya.
Zero. You should probably take the Albazim orb that we forgot, because they might need that, you know, by the way. It seems useful, but I'm pretty sure the Symbios army will also forget to use it on Fiel, so don't... Oh, never mind. He's gone. Nobody ever uses a silly orb anyway.
The owl just walked off into the ocean. Oh no, right, there's another boat there. That's the other warship. Right, as for us, what are we doing? I don't know. We're going after Domrick, I guess. Saraband? Why are we going to Saraband? I think that's what Rogan said, to go to Saraband, right? If it really was Rogan. Can we trust anyone anymore? You're all masked monks, probably. And we're just gonna leave Rogan locked up in that ship that's burning and sinking. Don't worry, I'll go find the keys, see ya! Luckily, in scenario one, we did get the key. Otherwise, he would be dead. We didn't even know why we were stealing it from Fiel, but now you know.
We're counting on you, Zero. All the way to zero. Because we can't count past your number. Hoot!
My time with the Medion army was brief. But like the Symbios army, you guys were terrible. This may be the last time we see each other, hopefully. But I'll try to forget you.
Yeah, same to you.
I'll pray for you. I guess.
I always wanted to see the capital. And then a loud whinny from a horse, like a big neigh thing. I just didn't want to make the sound effect. Sailing off into the sunset. Everyone has gone. No, it's not lonesome. We lost all the terrible people.
Oh, Julian. You certainly know how to make one wistful.
What? Why are you wistful? I don't understand that word, or you know.
Don't worry. I'm sure we'll meet again. It's not like we're in a trilogy or anything.
That's right, Prince Medion. We've been talking for like 20 minutes nonstop. Oh, we're gonna tow it behind us! We're a tugboat galleon. That's pretty good. I didn't think that would work. The chaos caused by the Rainbloods, which was the best part of this chapter by far, allowed the Medion army to rescue Gracia and the staff of Bessem, which hasn't done anything terribly amazing yet. After escaping by sea, they bested General Krawort, but General Rogan's life is in peril. Because no one has an axe. And knows how to break a wall. A diminished Medion army heads to Saraband. So yeah, there you go. Chapter 4, guys. Woo! We're done! I went a little bit off the rails, but I think it's more fun that way. I found, like, just as a close here for the end of the chapter and the end of the episode, which I may have had to split in half. You guys will know by now if I split it, but it's going to be like an hour long if I don't split it up. So that's why there wasn't an intro if there wasn't an intro. But yeah, sort of as a looking forward here, I found, like, I'm enjoying the voice acting. But the game is too verbose. There is too much... I don't know any other good word to describe it other than, like, verbosity, if that's a word. We'll make a word up. But, like, you know what I mean, guys? If you're still watching, you know, the ones that haven't left because it's too much of that. But, like, I find, like, they over-explain things a little bit much and say, like, it's just repetitive a little bit. So I feel like I might take some creative license from here on out because I think I will have more fun. Pretty sure I'll have more fun with that, and hopefully you guys can enjoy that. You know, if you want to read the exact text, it's on the screen. You can always read it yourself, but I'll be giving you the slightly modified blue version of things from here on out, I think. I think that'll be fun. It's something different to try anyway. And I need a way to sort of pep myself up, because I have been finding that some of the dialogue has been a bit dry to just read along, and just adding the accents for the different characters is not enough. I need to change a couple things up, like the owl that clearly shouldn't be able to speak. And some people, when they're just saying the same thing over and over again, I'm like, yeah, seriously. Like, a recap for people that didn't read it. The Walkyrie was the thing that we learned about in Scenario 1, that the Bolzome priests dug out of some archaeological dig. It's a giant floating warship weapon type thing that they've sent towards the Imperial Empire to destroy it. We didn't see it in Scenario 1, we just learned about it. In Scenario 2, it's the mystical thing that we don't know about, so we sent off Julian's army. But we'll probably never hear about it again. That will be reserved for Julian's story. So, you know, once we get to Scenario 3, we'll learn more about what that is and more about... I think at least one of the High Priests goes that way. We're going to deal with, like, Fial and... the other one. There's two that we beat up in Scenario 1. There's I think, one or two more that we'll beat up in this one. But Scenario 3 will reserve the really big enemies. Like, really the Vandals and stuff. And maybe the Rainbloods. Because how strong would you need to be to fight them? And I'm guessing the end of Scenario 1, which is about how strong we'll be at the end of Scenario 2, is not going to be strong enough to deal with Rainbloods. So maybe we'll have to wait till Scenario 3 for that. Anyway, I've certainly rambled on long enough. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the series. I'm having a good time, especially with my new outlook on life. Also, the next chapter, I can guarantee, I looked it up, Mithril Weapon Party. So not only will we be getting levels up, we're going to get a huge boost to our attack power as well as our stats. And things will... Well, we're going to have a lot less trouble with battles, let's just put it that way. So we'll finalize our 12-member party pretty soon. And we'll wrap this game up. Well, there's still two chapters, but, you know, we'll wrap it up maybe a little bit quicker, perhaps. So, yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you guys have enjoyed. And I'll see you next time for Chapter 5.